guys, my name is Yona. I'm a third year podiatric medical student at CSPM, and today we have a brand new episode for our awesome series of exploring all 9 podiatric medical schools. And if you guys don't know anything about this series is basically inspired by the idea that a lot of prospective students always ask us questions about different schools, and you know, we don't have the answers to all those, but we've asked some of our friends and our colleagues through Instagram and through social media to have them answer questions that we're always asked. And today we have a special guest with us. Her name is Janki. She goes by Tell Us About It on Instagram. She's an amazing person. I know I met her back in ACFAS in New Orleans, but she's an athlete, she's a runner, and she's really awesome. She is a fourth year at Scholl Podiatric Medical School. And without further ado, I'm happy to present to you Janki.
Hi, Dikshan Yona. This is Janki Patel from Scholl College of Podiatric Medicine. I'm a fourth year student here to answer some questions that prospective students may have about my school. So first question, what's the area like regarding things to do, eating, safety? We are in an incredibly safe location. We have a Navy base on 3 sides surrounding our campus. There are local restaurants and some takeout places to eat around campus within a few miles. And then things to do, we do have a lake very close to our campus that you can go to for a walk or a stroll. Otherwise, there's few trails that surround the campus. Most of the time, if you want to do more city activities, there's the city of Milwaukee or the city of Chicago, about an hour's drive both way. What's the living situation like in terms of pricing, distance from school, grocery stores? So we have a couple of living options surrounding our campus. There's on-campus housing, which is typical to what you would expect at a university. There's what's considered off-campus housing, but affiliated with our school, which is the place I stayed at. It's called the Woodlands. It has pet friendly options, which I had a cat throughout podiatry school. Both of those options are within walkable distance from our school. You just walk across a parking lot. Takes less than 5 to 10 minutes. Right across from our campus, across a major road, is Navy housing, which the Navy so kindly allows students to rent out. And that's more like individual unit type of house. So if you had a larger family, you could rent out a larger space that would have parking. Parking usually isn't an issue on our campus. You're just given a tag with your respective housing. And then there's also another parking tag for campus parking. Pricing is pretty competitive with Chicago unit pricing. So the Navy options are cheaper than the on-campus or the Woodlands housings, but they do range. You can get an individual unit or you can live with roommates based on your preference. Class sizes, so I believe Scholl matriculates between 95 to 100 students a year. Okay, so the next question is, does your school have research opportunities? Does your school have a research lab? So we do have a gate lab where research is conducted. We also have research opportunities through the Center for Lower Extremity Ambulatory Research. Typically between your first and your second year, you take a summer-long biomechanics course with a few breaks. If you were to be part of the CLEAR research cohort, you would take your biomechanics course at an accelerated level within 4 weeks, and you would spend the remainder of the 8 weeks performing research through an NIH-funded grant. Does your school have clubs and how active are they? So we do have clubs at all levels, ranging from student government to the student levels of the state and nationwide podiatric medical associations. Additionally, we have clubs geared towards service, geared towards, it wouldn't really be a club, but it's called the Interprofessional Community Clinic, which is a fully Rosalind Franklin student-run organization right next door to our campus. And students can spend time volunteering and helping to serve as part of the what we call the ICC. Does the school have a gym and a cafeteria located on campus? Yes, we have both. The cafeteria is just part of the campus. The gym is on the ground floor, accessible with your ID. There are some group fitness classes, and then there is a weight room. Are there any academic support services for students? So yeah, students in academic need are assigned a small group tutor, and there is also large group tutoring that podiatry students in the years above you will host in preparation for major exams to come. in the courses. Additionally, the professors are wonderful in terms of offering their office hours, being accessible via email or any form of communication that you may need, even offering to review exams that you may have already taken and to help for studying for upcoming exams. Are there any counseling services for students, mental health? So yes, there are counseling services at the RFU clinics specifically for students. What is your favorite part about my school? I don't know, I just love the community surrounding it. I felt it to be super, super supportive and motivating and energetic, and I absolutely love that from like the minute I stepped a foot on this campus. Does the school have a special group to help for family members or spouses acclimating to medical school? I don't know about that, so I can't answer that. Does your school offer scholarships? Yes, Scholl has incredible funding, and throughout the years from first year to fourth year, there are various scholarship opportunities. Usually they're annual, so when you apply to podiatry school, scholarships are given based on academic performance in undergrad or your graduate level previously, and then going through podiatry school, more scholarships will be given as you maintain academic performance. You can also apply to external scholarships that the APMSA, the American Podiatric Medical Student Organization, gives annually, in addition to other scholarships in honor of fellow physicians and their legacies. Do you need a car? Is there public transportation? So there is public transportation affiliated with the Metro line in Chicago, which is the form of transportation that runs from downtown to the suburbs. However, a car is incredibly, incredibly helpful, especially as you advance in your schooling, just because when you're first and second year, you can definitely commute onto campus or even maybe ask a friend to help you go to Target or get some groceries. There is a shuttle that goes to an area, like Target is connected to some other grocery stores, and so you can just take a shuttle weekly. However, I think having a car, especially because it's more of a suburban setting that the school is situated in, definitely helps. There is public transport, so there's another shuttle that brings students to and from the metro station if you were to commute from the downtown area. Are there any jobs that students can take on in the first years of school, such as peer tutors or note takers? So absolutely. Depending on the needs of the other students in the class, there may or may not be note takers per class, but there are definitely peer tutors. As you advance in schooling, you can also sign up to be a TA. There are also just need-based jobs on campus in terms of like working in the library or maybe working in a lab that provide funding. How often are certain facilities open for students, such as labs and the gym? So both the lab and the gym are on the same floor, they're on the ground floor, and they're accessible 24/7 with your student ID. Does the school have any special ties with the residency programs? There are a few programs that are affiliated with hospitals in Chicago. A lot of that, I believe, is based on the hospital that you become a resident in or would be serving a portion of your residency in. If it's a public hospital or just underfunded, sometimes Rosalind Franklin pays for the salaries of those residents, and so therefore it's a special tie with the Scholl College. Any other information that I think could help prospective students? How supportive is my class? I love my class. My class is super fun and easy to work with. We definitely cheer each other on, and like I said, the atmosphere on my campus is definitely something I've loved from my interview day. I was a former Scholl ambassador once again because I love repping Scholl, and I would definitely say I don't think it's on me to sell the school. I think the college sells itself. Definitely commit to a college that makes you happy and where you feel like the environment is conducive to learning, because it's 2 years on campus, but then even beyond that, you're a student for 4 years in total, and that's like a long time for life to pass by. So choose somewhere where you want to be and somewhere that makes you happy, and you'll do well.